Guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well. I hope you've been having a fantastic day. If you're in the UK, I hope you're not too cooped up inside because it's really, really warm and muggy at the moment. Sadly, I think it will probably end at some point by the weekend. But you know what? It's just nice to have at least 4 or 5 days of fairly nice weather. If you're anywhere else in the world, you probably won't be able to. You probably won't fully understand the significance of getting 5 days of sunny weather in the UK because you'll probably get a few months of it, and other people might get a few months of rain. It all depends where you are, but that is the weather forecast where I am right now. And yeah, it's feeling very close and muggy in this room at the moment. So that said, a big thank you to everybody that has subscribed, that has joined me in the comments, that have suggested music in the comments, and also through Buy Me a Coffee. I do take your suggestions seriously. I write them down and I try and get to them at a time that I feel is appropriate. Sometimes if I know the group, I kind of have a feeling that the vibe or maybe the title of a song would be best played at a certain time. So I kind of put that one on hold. But sometimes I have not got a clue about the band or the artist, and it's just such a joy to react to completely unknown music. So that said, I'm reacting now to a singer called Eddie Money. I've never heard of this guy, and the track is called Take Me Home Tonight. I think it was from 1986, but what I have actually got, and I've just like opened it, is you know, I don't know if you can see that, it's probably reversed actually, but it actually says the Billboard book of top 40 hits. So that would be the Billboard Hot 100, and I'm just going to have a look to see what we've got for Eddie Money. Okay, so surprisingly, he was around for quite a while. The first track that he had out was in 1978, Baby Hold On. It's had quite a good track record, actually. Maybe not that so many tracks every year, but yeah, Take Me Home Tonight was, in fact, Take Me Home Tonight is his best, his most successful, commercially successful track. And that peaked at number 4. And September of 1986. So there you go. And this would actually be the second song I've reacted to tonight from 1986. So I wonder if that's going to be a theme for the evening. But yeah, it's and this track was taken from an album called Can't Hold Back, which was released in August 1986. So that said, I don't know very much about, I've got no information about Eddie Money at all. So if you want to kind of fill me in with some details after the song, please do. I love to read about new artists, especially ones that have been around for quite a while. I kind of feel that I'm missing out on their history. So, but yeah, let's get down to it. Let's have a look, listen to what this is about. Eddie Money, Take Me Home Tonight. Now, this could be a, I'm going to take a quick guess. This could be a, maybe a ballad of some kind. Take Me Home Tonight. Be like a love song or something. I honestly don't know. It sounds very romantic anyway, I guess. So yeah, without further ado, this is live, I think. So let's get playing. So yeah, I'm only guessing, but I think this might be a studio performance, which was live, but the music kind of sounds a little bit, not detached, but it does sound like it's a little bit too well produced to be live. So maybe this is like a dubbed version. But anyway, I'm gonna play one, and yeah, hopefully this is good. Sounds like it could be quite up-tempo as well.
Wonder when I feel with my appetite, with all the
I'm loving this so far. I didn't expect this. I kind of had this down as a ballad, but this kind of feels more rock orientated. I'm really fascinated with his look, actually, because it, and this is going to sound, it's going to sound dumb as hell, but I just watched The Breakfast Club, and he kind of reminds me of Bender from The Breakfast Club, but an older version. But he also reminds me of Sylvester Stallone's brother, Frank Stallone. And if you told me this was Frank Stallone, with my vague memory of what Frank Stallone, I probably would have believed it. And Frank Stallone, I think he had a couple of maybe songs like that, where I think one of them was on a Staying Alive. I think that was it, the sequel to Saturday Night Fever. Anyway, but yeah, I'm loving this guy. He's got a lot of character. He's kind of got a little bit of a Huey Lewis's around about him as well. And that was a great thing about, those days back in the 80s, that especially with rock and stuff, you could be, yeah, you know what, you could look like somebody's uncle and he could still be really cool on stage, or somebody's dad. I mean, this guy, certainly he's not young. I don't know how old he is in 1986, but it was very acceptable, guys rocking away. Singers, it was really cool, and I think I miss that today because everybody seems really young. I mean, I know that's just me as an older person actually commenting it, but it's just such a shame that there's not that depth of the wisdom that comes out in the certain music that you're thinking, that's from a life experience. But when a sort of 20-year-old and 18-year-old's thinking about a life experience, it's, you don't really kind of buy into it so much. Anyway, this is absolutely fantastic, and I love that bit that this lady's singing there about the Ronettes, because that reminded me of something that's I mean, I've heard of the Ronettes as well. So Be My Baby, Be My Baby, it's that's a song as well, I'm pretty sure. Anyway,
don't
carry on. Oh, it's lagging a bit. Man, that was good. That was really good. That was really, really good. I everything that I could wish in an 80s rock song was right there. You had the encore bit at the end where it was just everybody singing. You had the saxophone break. You had the roaring guitars and the chorus. you had the backing singer with such a beautiful line that gave it a lot more sort of depth and dimension. This was a really, really, I can't even think what this song's about, but but this was really, really cool. Listen, I could imagine just sitting in a car listening to this with the, you know, the windows down. Man, this is good on a summer's day too. So it does feel like it definitely feels like a jump in a car song. Really, really does. If I'd been in the car, you know, I would have probably been like rocking out to this, probably hit something in the process. But yeah, this was fantastic. Eddie Money, what a voice. I mean, obviously, because it looked like it was a live version, but slightly dubbed, which I don't care about because to actually just see him on stage and hear what I think is probably the produced studio version, that's fine with me. And I'm sure his voice was great anyway, but I know it's really, really good just to see him all together. And it's just a really good sort of zinging rock track. And I actually thought this was going to be a romantic ballad or something, but how wrong can you be from the title? So this was really, really cool. Definitely want to hear anything else by this guy, maybe. Just see if... I don't really think what else to say. I mean, everything about this track was just perfect for the 80s. The lyrics, I guess, because I wasn't really actually listening to the lyrics. Sometimes I do that. I'm kind of so involved with the vibe of the sounds of the instruments. And there was maracas in there as well. I'm sure that was a maraca. Anyway, lyrics. I feel a hunger. It's a hunger that tries to keep a man awake at night. Are you the answer? I shouldn't wonder when I can feel you whet my appetite. With all the power you're releasing, it isn't safe to walk the city streets alone. Anticipation is running through me. Let's find the key and turn this engine up. That's definitely an 80s verse, if ever I heard one. Anticipation is running through me. Let's find the key and turn this engine on. I can feel you breathe. I can feel your heartbeat faster. Take me home tonight. I don't want to let you go. Till you see the light, take me home tonight. Listen, honey, just like a runnet said, be my little baby. I get frightened in all this darkness. I get nightmares. I hate to sleep alone. I need some company, a guardian angel, to keep me warm when the cold winds blow. I can feel you breathe. I can feel your heartbeat faster. Yeah, I mean, the lyrics were quite sort of straightforward. And I think it's a guy who... Maybe he's met a girl and she just kind of like does that thing for him where, you know, it's just one of those attraction things. And whether she's attracted to him, I don't know, but he's definitely attracted to her and he can see himself with her. It's just a really, really cool song. I've got nothing else to say on this, but it really has energized me. I've listened to two songs now tonight from 86 and just something about the vibe I've got. It's, you know, it's all kind of coming together. I feel really, really good. And I'm so glad I did some reactions because I don't always do reactions of a school night. I like to do them at the weekend, but I'm trying to sort of be a bit more regular with reactions and do more, you know, when I kind of get chance. And especially if I'm feeling quite awake, then it's really, really good. Sometimes I feel quite tired after a day at work. So, but anyway, this one was... a super, super song to listen to. But before I go, I'm just going to check see if anyone's said anything about these. Gives me goosebumps to listen to this. Yeah, I mean, I wasn't getting goosebumps from it, but I was, you know, it's just giving me a lot of energy listening to this. It was real rip-roaring rock. I love Eddie Money, although this hit was not my favourite. Okay. Might have been lip sync for TV, but I saw him live in Tahoe in the 90s, and he killed it. Check out his midnight special performance of Two Tickets to Paradise. Okay, well, if anybody else suggests that song, I will react to it. I would want my money back on every concert there if they were just lip-syncing. I think it was actually just dubbed, to be honest. I think that was just dubbed. So, anyway, if there's anything else you can tell me about this song, then please do. Anything else you can tell me about this artist, please do. And if that track that was mentioned in the comments is a good one to listen to, then of course I will take that suggestion up, because I love a bit of 80s rock and it really kind of just gets me in the mood. So, folks, take care. Have a wonderful rest of the week, and I'll speak to you all soon.